Hi everyone, it's Marianne from MIP Mix channel. We are doing now the replacing on the Toyota Yaris 2012. Now we have to replace the sensor, ABS sensor on left side, rear left side. I had some troubles, on the dashboard. I had some kind of lights on, so I replaced the battery. That problem stops, and after a few months came again on. So I bought meantime the sensor. You can see it now. It's a kind of a cable, and that cable is coming inside of the trunk, and we have to remove this cover. And I never did this operation before, so I'm trying to figure out how to take it out. There are some screws, as you can see, and there are some clips or kind of brackets who are keeping it together. So as you can see, I'm moving it not very strong, just to see how it is assembled and to make sure I'm not gonna break everything, something on that. In order to have a better access and to be able to remove the plastic cover, which is pretty big there, I took out the, I move a little bit the spare, spare wheel, and as you can see, it's better access there. I was able to pull it out, and for me, I was curious to see how everything is done there, because as I told you, never did that operation on this car or on the other, any other car I had before. So you can see here the lights in the trunk, it's open. In the back it is a kind of a plug, and you'll see how you have to take it out. Now I was able to move that a little bit. If I want to take it completely out, I have to take off the bench. So here is the plug for the light. I tried to take out in a way, and I brought a screwdriver, a small one, and with that one I, it's a little clips there, and I was able to pull it out safely and with no problems for it. So after that, you can see here the cable is coming inside the trunk. It's a hole there. It's covered with a rubber piece. And the plug is going a little further up. And here I start to figure out how to unplug it. I took out my gloves because I didn't know how to eat. I didn't feel it as I wished to. Here I found out where I had to push it. And you can see, I put it back now, easy, and look how easy it was to remove it. Push on that clips and it's coming out so easy. But when you did it, and here I use the screwdriver to push down the rubber piece and pull out the cable of the sensor under the car. Here you have to use a 10 millimeter key to take out that bracket. There are two, and I use a wrench, a key like that to work faster. Now I put a new one inside, a new cable of the new sensor, and I went up until I was able to fix it back on the plug, and I leave it there not to come out, and then I continue what I started. Good. Now you have to put back the rubber piece, which is coming a new one. It's a kind of a shoulder there. You have to push it a little bit with a screwdriver to go through the hole. And then we go. I went back in the trunk, and I push it down from the inside to be well fixed on the wheel. You see here, I push it from the inside, came on the place, and now it's correct. So now I have to put back the bracket of the new cable, of the new sensor. I'm using some anti-seize paste, because as you saw before, when I took out the screw, it was rusty, and I want to prevent the damaging. So I put some anti-seize paste, it's just protecting against the rust. And with the same key, a 10 millimeter key, the same screw, I put it back on the frame, tight it well, and continue the job. As you can see, I start to put the screw back by hand. I was afraid not to destroy the thread. When I was sure it started well, I tightened it. So now we have to remove the second bracket of the cable sensor, which is down on close to the wheel. Here too, you need a 10 millimeter key. I had to use a tubular one longer to work faster. You can use, if you don't have this kind of key, if you have a fixed one, you can use that one. It's gonna take a little longer, but it's okay. And now I clean up a little bit that dust and with a brush, and fix back the new one. Here I add to some paste, anti-seize paste, protection against corrosion, tight it well back, and then you have to go to the next position. So now the destruction began. Here I don't know exactly how it is fixed inside of that beam. You can see it's pretty tight. I don't know exactly how it is and where I have to push with the screwdriver. And I was watching to see how it is fixed, the new one. I was trying, and there is a problem because it's the strut there and the helicoil dial spring there, and I don't have a good position to work there. Instead, I had to find a good angle for the phone to film. So I pulled that wires until they broke, and then I was trying with the screwdriver. I wasn't able to take it out, and then I used this long nose, and with this one I was able to break that outside plug and came out. Well, ideally I wish to have it out by hand or by screwdriver. I couldn't. So now I check the new screwdriver. I put it on the position. It has a kind of a cover, plastic cover.
And here I went down and click, and that's it. Solid, it's okay now. So you can see here how it looks inside of the car. It's dirty. Here I found a hole. I saw some water inside of the trunk. I have to cover that wheel compartment with some silicone. And it's not nice to see. So now I in meantime start a friend came there and he helped me with the filming. He kept the camera. Here I put back the plug for the lights, and those are the little brackets who are going, and you have to push them, hit them a little bit by hand, and they are making click. And we fix them well, and the job is done. The job is really done. You will need just to rearrange what to take out. Don't forget the screws you took out when you disassembled it. On this case, there are only three. And here it's a 10 millimeter key too. In the top you have a screwdriver, Phillips one. Tie them well and put all the other covers back. And the job is done. This is just story what you have to do. That is the cover where it's coming the rod. In the autumn I make a treatment, oil treatment for the winter, anti-rust proof, and I don't know how I touching and what I touching under the car, as I was trying, I was struggling to take out that that sensor out, and I touch my head with a lot of grease. So the job is done. Congratulations. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Good roads to have, I wish you. Bye bye.